We got a young man who's a former Muslim. He's no longer a Muslim. He's heard some questions about Christianity from Muslim debaters, so he has questions. So he's going to remain anonymous. So I'm going to answer those questions to the best of my ability. So I need your prayers, because only the Holy Spirit is all-knowing, that the Lord Jesus fills me with the Spirit, and that the Holy Spirit will convict this man to see the truth of the gospel and give his life to Jesus Christ, because he's already left Islam. So pray, because anything good, anything perfect that we do is the work of the Holy Spirit in and through us as we yield to the Holy Spirit. So Father, we ask you to take over the session, and I ask for this favor. Here's the objection. But in Matthew 5, 21, 22, our Lord said the following. You have heard that it was said to the people long ago, you shall not murder. And anyone who murders will be subject to the judgment. But I tell you that anyone who's angry with a brother. Now the NIV, which I'm reading here, which I should be on the King James, it's okay. Says brother or sister will be subject to judgment. Again, anyone who says to a brother or sister, raka, or fool, right, is answerable to the court. Anyone who says you fool will be in danger of the fire of hell. So the Muslims say Jesus contradicts himself. Jesus contradicts himself because he said you shouldn't call anyone a fool. But if you go to Matthew 23, Jesus calls these self-righteous Pharisees and scribes, brood of vipers, whitewashed sepulchres. He calls them fools. Isn't that a contradiction? Isn't that a contradiction? Now, let me give you the answer that I gave this young man. No, because if you read Matthew 5:22, thank our brother, Protestant and Catholic, got it already. You don't say this to your brother. Brother. The Pharisees opposed Jesus. The scribes opposed Jesus. Were not the brothers of Christ. They were the enemies of Christ, the sons of the devil. So there isn't a contradiction, right? Because it's directed towards your brother, and even then says without a cause. That's in the King James Version. So that means even there's a time and place where even a brother can be rebuked severely for acting like a heathen. And let me show you who the brothers of Jesus are. In Matthew 12, 46 to 50. Matthew 12. Now, brother, if you want to turn there, that's fine, or I can read it for you. Which is easier?
If you want me to read it, I have this app called Bible Hub. I can just type it in.
Okay, Matthew 12, 46 to 50. Okay. If that's going to be easier for you. If not, I'll read. But go to Matthew 12, with Matthew 12, 46
Matthew
to 50.
12.
Yeah, 46 to 50.
46, all right.
When you get there, read it for me. Matthew 12, 46 to 50, to see who are the brothers and sisters of Christ.
All right, so I'm starting on Matthew 12, 46, mm-hmm. while Jesus, and I'm reading the New International Version.
If you're comfortable with that, feel free. Go ahead.
While Jesus was still talking to the crowd, his mother and brothers stood outside, wanting to speak with him.
Keep going. What are you stopping?
Someone told him, your mother and brothers are standing outside, wanting to speak with you. He replied to them, who is my mother and who are my brothers? Pointing to his disciples, he said, here are my mothers and my brothers.
Who are my mother and brothers? Now he's going to answer the question. Who are they?
And now I'm on Matthew 12:50. For whoever does the will of my Father in heaven is my brother and my sister and mother.
Okay, so who is Jesus's mother, brothers, and sisters? Those who do the will of the Father in heaven, right?
Whoever does the will of the Father of Jesus.
Okay, now go to Matthew 17, verse 5. And what is the Father's will? What is God's will? Matthew 17, verse 5.
All right, 1 second. Matthew 17, verse
Yeah, and if it's
12.
Getting tiring for you to read, I'll read for you. Just let me know.
While he was still speaking, a bright cloud covered them, and a voice from the cloud said, this is my son, whom I love. With him I am well pleased. Listen to him.
So did you see in Matthew 17, verse 5, the Father himself testified and said to the disciples of Jesus, Peter, James, and John, this is the Son whom I love, my beloved Son. With him I am well pleased. Listen to him. So what is the Father's will?
The Father's will is that, I'm sorry, say that again.
What is the Father's will?
The Father's will, I don't know. There's actually something wrong. This is my Son whom I love. With him I am well pleased. Listen to him.
So what is the Father's will for you? What does he want you to do?
I'm sorry, I didn't get your question. So it's his listen to his son, Jesus Christ.
So then the Pharisees and the scribes who rejected Jesus and condemned Jesus, were they his brothers?
No.
So then where did Jesus contradict himself?
He didn't contradict himself.
So when the Muslims try to bring this out as a contradiction, that shows you they're desperate, right?
Yeah.
All right. Now,
you take a lot of things out of context.
100%. So you're seeing it. Now, let me show you again what the Father's will is. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, go to John 6.
All right, John 6.
When you get there, chapter 6. John chapter 6.
Just John chapter 6?
When you get there, I want you to read verses 39 and 40. John 6, verses 39 and 40.
All right.
Read that for me.
And this is the will of who, this is the will of him who sent me, that I shall lose none of all those he has given to me, but raise them up on the last day, which I'm assuming is the day of judgment.
Yep. And then what does it say in 40?
40. It says, for my Father's will is that everyone who looks to the Son and believes in him shall have eternal life, and I will raise them up at the last day.
So and John records Jesus saying that the Father's will for everyone is to do what? What does the Father want you to do?
Listen to his Son, Jesus Christ.
And if you do, Jesus Christ, his Son, will then give you everlasting life and resurrect you at the last day, right?
Yes, eternal life.
And so if you reject Jesus, then you're not his brother. Who are you then? Go to John 8, John chapter 8, and read verse 44. John chapter 8, verse 44.
All right, I'm typing that in, John 28.
Chapter 8. Verse 44.
Verse 44, all right. You belong to your father, the devil, and you want to carry out your father's desires. He was a murderer from the beginning, not holding to the truth. For there is no truth in him. When he lies, he speaks his native language, for he is a liar and the father of lies.
So those who reject Jesus and don't believe in Jesus, their fathers who?
Their fathers are liars.
No, read it again. Their fathers who?
Are the father of lies.
Who is their father? Read it again.
When he lies, he speaks his native language. Okay. For he is a liar and the father of lies.
Who is he? My mother? Who is he? It's in front of you.
I'm sorry. I don't understand the Bible.
No, you understand.
Well.
You understand it. Read, brother. Read. It's context. My but it's right there.
You belong to your father, the devil.
So who is their father?
The devil.
See, my friend, don't get into it. It's easy, brah.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I just don't. I've read some of the Quran and the Bible, and I just don't understand it. Homie, you okay, man? You're getting defensive.
So, you just read, if you don't believe in Jesus, you belong to your father, the devil. The devil is your father. That means you're not the brother of Jesus, right?
Yeah.
So where's the contradiction?
Your father is the devil if you reject Jesus Christ.
Yeah, so where's the contradiction?
There is no contradiction.
See, that's it. Now, you asked another question, if you want to repeat it, about Jesus saying, I'm the Father one. What was that question? Because I didn't answer that one.
So there's the Unitarian Christians and there's Trinitarian Christians, and also the Muslims side with the Unitarian Christians on this. The Unitarians say that when Jesus said, I and the Father are one, he's talking about I and the Father are one in meaning and purpose. But the Trinitarians will say, I and the Father are one, like as in like the Trinity way, like they are one.
Remember how I laughed? Can I laugh again?
Yeah.
Okay, so remember,
it sounds funny what the Muslims and Unitarians say.
Let me repeat,
but I'm still a little bit unsure about it.
Yeah, let me repeat for the Christians listening. The Muslims quote the Unitarian saying, when Jesus said, I am the Father one, it means one in purpose, not their one God. So this was my reaction. All right, now with that said, are we ready?
Yeah.
Okay, let's see.
You want me to type in the verse?
Yeah, now, but before you do that, let's see who's interpreting correctly. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, go to John 10, 27 to 30. John 10, 27 to 30.
John 10, 27
to 30. To 30. Yeah, let's read the context now.
Okay.
Okay, read 27 and 28. Just read those two verses to start with.
All right, remember, I have to go verse by verse, so I'm going to
pause. That's okay. So read 27 and then 28, and then I'm going to ask you some questions. Go ahead.
All right, my sheep listen to my voice. I know them and they follow me. I gave them eternal life, and they shall never perish. No one will snatch them out of my hand.
Okay, now let me ask you a question. Jesus says that he himself will give everlasting life, life that never ends, to all his sheep. They will never perish, can never be destroyed, because there's no one that will pluck them out of his hand. His hand is a metaphor meaning his power and care. If you're in his hand, you're in his power and his care, and because he's almighty, no one can destroy you if you're in his hand, right?
Yes.
Does that sound like a mere human prophet, a human creature?
No, that sounds someone with some, at least some divine attributes.
Excellent. No human prophet, and you ask the Unitarian and the Muslim, can you show me where Muhammad or Moses spoke like this? Nobody speaks like this. Jesus, I give them everlasting life. No one can pluck them out of my hand. They're my sheep. They hear my voice. And then now, read 29, verse 29.
29, all right, I'm going to it. My Father, who has given them to me, is greater than all. No one can snatch them out of my Father's hand. And then John 10:30. I and the Father are one.
Okay, now let's look at the context. No one can pluck them out of my hand. No one can pluck them out of my Father's hand. In this sense, we are one. So in what way are they one?
And they're followers, like, you know, they're followers and no one can snatch them out of their hands.
So if no one can snatch them out of their hands, that means they're one in power, right?
They're one in power and they both grant eternal life if you follow them.
Okay, so then why would a Unitarian tell me it means they're only one in purpose?
Because I guess they just took that one verse out of context and reinterpreted it.
Exactly. See, you see, God is blessing you because you're smart and you're seeing it. Now, let me give you further proof. Jesus is claiming to be God in the flesh, even though he's different from the Father. That's why we're Trinitarians, because the Father is not the Son. The Son's not the Father. They're distinct persons, but they're one in their power. Let me give you further proof. Are you ready for further proof?
Yes.
And before we go on, remember what Jesus said. You just read it. My sheep hear my voice. So believers are his sheep. They hear his voice. They're in his hand, in his care, right?
And he grants them eternal life.
Eternal life, and no one can snatch out of his hand, right?
Yes.
Okay, go to Deuteronomy 32, verse 39. Deuteronomy in the Old Testament, 32, verse 39.
32, verse 39. All right. Mm-hmm. Just typing that in. Yeah. All right.
What does it say? What does the true God say there?
See, now that I myself am here, there is no God besides me.
Reread that one more time. It's not I'm here. See, now that I myself am he. Read it one because you said
here. Oh, am he. My bad.
Yeah, read it one more time.
See, now that myself am he, there is no God besides me. I put to death and bring to life. I have wounded and I will heal. And no one can deliver out of my hand.
Sure sounds like what Jesus said, right?
Yeah.
Did Jesus say no one can deliver, snatch out of my hand?
Yeah, Jesus just said that. For when Muslims claim that he's just a prophet, he says a lot of things that only God could say.
He says the things only God can say. Notice what God said here. Here's proof that I am the only God. I make alive and no one can deliver out of my hand. But Jesus says, I'm the one who gives everlasting life and no one can deliver out of my hand. Wow. Now let's go to Isaiah 43, the book of Isaiah, chapter 43, verse 13.
Isaiah 33, verse 14.
43. Isaiah chapter 43, verse 13.
All right. Yes. And from ancient days, I am he. No one can deliver out of my hand. When I act, who can reverse it?
So again, God says no one can deliver out of my hand?
Yes.
And Jesus says no one can deliver out of my hand?
Yes. So I guess what Jesus meant by that is him and the Father are one in having the power and no one can snatch them out of their hand.
Now, can a creature be one with the Father in power?
Yes.
A creature can? So a creature can be
all. No, not a creature. No, I thought you're talking about Jesus.
No, can
only
a
Jesus
creature,
can be one with the Father
creature,
in power.
A creature be one with God in power?
No, not a prophet or not a messenger, but only Jesus.
And yet Jesus says he is one with the Father in power because he's not a creature, right? Because that's why he's speaking like he's the God of the Old Testament, right?
Yes.
But don't forget the final one, final line, where he said, they are my sheep, they hear my voice, they're in my hand, right?
Yeah, he says my. He doesn't say the Father's,
yeah,
he says
sheep,
my. And then he
my
goes
voice.
On to say, I and the Father are one.
Yeah, but I want you to focus. My sheep hear my voice, they're in my hand, right?
Yes.
Go to Psalm 95. Psalm 95, verses 6 to 8. Psalm 95, verses,
Psalm 95.
Verses 6 to 8.
All right.
Pay attention to what Jehovah says, or what it said about Jehovah.
All right. Come, let us bow down and worship. Let us kneel before the Lord our Maker. And it was in all caps, so it's referring to Yahweh.
Yep.
For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture, the flock under his care. Today, if only you would hear his voice. Do not harden your hearts
before
as
you, move
you
on,
did to
Meribah. Before you move on, pay attention. We are the people of his pasture, the flock under his care, and we are to hear his voice, huh?
Yeah, just like a shepherd and his flock of sheep.
But why is the psalmist saying, we are the sheep of Jehovah under his care, his hand, and we are to hear his voice? But Jesus says, they're my sheep, they hear my voice, they're in my hand, in my care.
Because him and the Father are one.
Okay, so then why would a Muslim say that Jesus is not claiming to be God here?
Because they did the typical take a verse out of context.
Yeah, you got it, man. So God is really working in you. May he complete the work he's beginning in you. So that was the second question.